Hi friends, let us start in today's class Integration of Karnataka. Our Karnataka is situated in southwestern part of our India. Its neighboring states are Goa, Maharashtra, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu and Kerala. Its length is 750 kilometers and its width is 400 kilometers. Its area is 1,91,791 square kilometers. It is the 8th largest state with regard to the area. According to 2011 census, it got 9th position with a population. At present days, there are 30 districts in our state and there is a 176 taluks, 747 hoblies, 347 towns and 27,481 villages are there. Belagavi district is the largest district in the size and Bengaluru urban district is the smallest district. We are all know that Bengaluru is a capital of our Karnataka. Our state have been divided into four parts for the purpose of administrative system. Those are Bengaluru, Mysore, Belagavi, Kalaburgi. Now let's see a historical background of our Karnataka or integration movement. The name Karnataka has been used from ancient times. This land is used to be called as a Karunadu, Karu plus Nadu. Its meaning is a land of black soil. A book called Kavirajya Marga, which is written by Sri Vijaya in the court of Amoghavarsha. Amoghavarsha is a king of Rashtrakuta dynasty. In that book, we see the Kannada land has been stretched from the Kaveri to Godavari river. Many powerful dynasties are ruled in this area, like Shatavahanas, Kadambas, Gangas, Chalukyas, Pallavas, Rashtrakutas, so those have been ruled in this area. After the decline of Vijayanagar Empire in this area, it means Kannada speaking people's area comes under the many political disputes. Force which were the politically more powerful at the time of reduced Kannada and Kannadigas to nothing. After the death of Tipu Sultan, the British transformed the Kannada area, the Karnataka area to control the political power with different languages. Kannadigas or the Kannada speaking peoples experienced the suffering of being forced to live under the Marathas and Nizam's rule. On that time, the Kannadigas have been felt to be independent and they started movement in order to escape from this situation and they wanted to build their own state. This movement is called as an integration movement. First integration call have been given by the Mumbai Karnataka's people. Karnataka Vidayavarthaka Sangha was started in the year 1890 under the presidentship of R.H. Deshpande. He was given the original form of the concept of integration. On that time, initial stage of this movement have been started. And many other movements have been started. Those are Kannada Sahitya Parishad have been started in the year 1915. Karnataka Sabha have been started in the year 1916. In the year 1924, the Congress session have been held at Belgaum. On that time, the Narayana Rao was a leader of the integration movement. He was singing a welcome song called Udayavagali Namma Chaluva Kannada Nadu as a welcome song. On that session, we see that the president of that session was Mahatma Gandhiji. Through this activity, the people of Karnataka have been showed that what is the importance of integration movement in our India. The independence is more important. Integration movement have been progressed along with the freedom movement supplementing it. 20 administrative centers of Karnataka, Madras, Karnataka, Ballari, South Kannada, Nilgiri district and other taluks of British administration, Mumbai, Karnataka, North Kannada, Dharwad, Bijapur, Belgaum and other three taluks of British administration. The chief commissioner administrators British administration, Cantonment, Karnataka, Belgaum and Bengaluru, they are the military stations of the British administration. Mysore, Mandya, Hasan, Shumoga, Tumkur, Chikmangalur, Chitradurga, Kolar and Bengaluru. Mysore provinces. Hyderabad provinces, Gulbarga, Bidar, Raichur districts, Hyderabad, it is related to Hyderabad provinces. 7 to 20 is 14 small provinces, totally 20 administrative centers on the time of integration. Now let's see what is the role of newspapers and literature in the field of on the time of integration movement. The daily newspapers, weekly magazines and literary works are totally inspired the integration movement. In nowadays also we see that the mass media have been played a more important to communicate with each other to get information about different aspects or different fields. Now let's see. The important are the famous newspapers related to the Bombay Karnataka are Vijaya. Those are Vijaya, Raja Hamsa, Kannada Kesari, Karnataka Vaibhava. Now let's see which are the famous newspapers related to the Mysore provinces. Those are Suryodaya, Prakashika, Hitabodhini, Virutanta Chintamani, Mysore Herald. Many peoples are far to the Karnataka state, Kannada language, Kannada culture. One of them are Alur Venkata Rao. On that time he say, where is our Karnataka? He turns like a piece of cloth in the place of distribution in various provinces. Who will take up the task of stitching those pieces and make one integral state who has much pride to his state? To making or to show the prestige of Kannada people and understand the glory of their own land, language and their culture, and through that objectives, the Alur Venkata Rao, he was published a book called The Past Glory of Our Karnataka. A Past Glory of Karnataka. When the people are seen this book, the peoples have been encouraged his thoughts and the Hyderabad Karnatakas or Hyderabad Kannadigas facilitated him or given a title him in the year 1941 as a title called Karnataka Kuladipaka, a family saint of Karnataka. This book became a source to awakening among the Mumbai Karnataka people or Mumbai Kannadigas. In order to collect funds for Kannada Sahitya Sammelana, he went singing from door to collect money. He was singing a poem of Kuyampu's poem called Jaya He Karnataka Mate. It is our Rashtragite. And Mecheva Nala Ade Karnataka. Those poems are touched the lack of people on that time. Narayana Rao's poem called Udayavagali Namma Chaluva Kannada Nadu became very popular on that time. The first national kavi of our Karnataka is Munjeshwar Govinda Pai. He fought for the Kannadigas including in Karnataka till the end. Many more poets have been written and inspired the Kannadigas greatly. Many poets wrote about the importance of our Kannada land and Kannada culture. And its importance on that time the lack of people have been turned into the integration movement. Now let's see the post-independence integration movement. This have been divided into three categories. Now let's see one by one. Now let's see for first stage. This stage started from 1947 and ends in 1948. Before the 1947, we see that two types of states are there in our country. First one is British ruled Indian provinces and second one is 562 princely kingdoms are there in our country. On that time, now let's see our second stage. It was in the year 1953. In 1951 and 1952, we see that the general election of Lok Sabha has been held in our Karnataka, and this election was After the election, we see that the extremist-minded party called Integral Karnataka State Creation Parishad emerged in the year 1952. This party was started Satyagraha for integration, and about 5,000 people were imprisoned. And that time the chief minister of our Karnataka was Kengal Hanumanthayya. He was totally supported to the integration movement. We see another case of division of our India on the basis of linguistic. Those are the 1952. We see that a Andhra leader called Putti E. Sriramalu. He was demanded integration for Andhra Pradesh or Andhra provinces, and he went on fast for the 58 days, and later he was died. There were a widespread rallies in Andhra Pradesh. After the Sriramalu's death, the Prime Minister Nehru declared that the central government has decided to create the state of Andhra. According to Andhra, state was formed in the year 1953. Accordingly, we see that the Andhra Pradesh is a state was formed in the year 1953. When the Andhra Pradesh was created on the basis of language, the 7th taluk of our Ballari district was merged with Mysore provinces. This was the second stage of integration. Now let's see a final stage. It was started in the year 1956. After the creation of Andhra Pradesh on the basis of language, on that time the many states have been divided. Many states were fought for their own language. On that time, the demand for the reorganization of our India based on the language, the central government appointed a committee called the State Reorganization Committee to give a report. The president of this committee was Fazil Ali. This committee is also called as a Fazil Ali Committee. This committee have been gave its report in the year 1956. Accordingly, the reorganization of a state was based on the language and language of their conversations and of their administration. All the parties have been accepted this matter and respected the committee's report also, but Kannadigas protested against the inclusion of Kasargod in Kerala state. And about Ballari district, that Ballari should be separated from the Mysore and that a new state should be called as a Mysore state. The Fazil Ali's report has recommended the most part of Ballari to Andhra state. The central government has totally accepted the decision of Mysore Assembly regarding to the Ballari district, and integration of Karnataka state come into existence on November 1, 1956. In the name it is called as a Vishala Karnataka state. First one is Mysore inclusive of Ballari district. 10 districts, those are Mysore, Mandya, Bangalore, Kolar, Hasan, Tumkuru, Chikmagalur, Shumoga, Chitradurga and Ballari. Second one is 4 districts of Mumbai state, Belgaum, Dharwad, Bijapur. Third one is South Kannada district. The South Kannada district except Kasargod taluk and Koligal taluk of Coimbatore district. Fourth one is Coorg district. Fifth one is 3 district of Hyderabad state. Those are Kalaburgi, Raichur and Bidar. Totally we see that only 19 districts were there. In nowadays we see the 30 districts are there in our state. The Kengal Hanumanthayya was a former chief minister of Mysore state. And he was trying to bring an awareness among the people for the unified state of Kannadigas. Yes, Nijalingappa was the first chief minister of Mysore state formed in the year 1956 on November 1st. In 1973, the chief minister called D. Devaraja Aras named the Mysore state as a Karnataka state.
Thank you for watching this video. With the